of how dealing with the fairies can be a really bad thing, or it can be really a good thing. It all depends on your perspective. You see, there was, in a small village, a man with a hump on his back. And he was the soul of good. Lusmore would do anything for anybody. Carry this, Lusmore. Take this to the market, Lusmore. Oh, can you help me with my thatch, Lusmore? And he would do it, even with the hump on his back. One day, he was asked to take some things to market in the next town, and he went. But as he was coming back, it was late, and he decided, I don't think I'm going to make it back. Let me sleep here by this bridge. And he lay down and went to sleep. As he was falling asleep, beautiful music through his ears. He listened. He got up and said, I wonder who's singing. That is beautiful. He crept very gently over to the river, and on the bank of the river, the fairies trooped and were dancing and singing in the moonlight. And as they sang, he began to sing with them. A little at first, and more and more. Finally, he was singing and he was adding to their music. And the fairy, who sings with us, who gives us this beauty? And they saw him. The fairies have seen me. But they looked at him and whispered, and looked at the hump on his back, looked up at him, and said, Lusmore, Lusmore, doubt not nor deplore, for the hump that you bore on your back is no more. All of a sudden, he stood straight. There was no hump. Moved himself and smiled, and they sang to him, and he sang back, and they added his melody to theirs. As the sun rose, he went back to his room, and nobody recognized him. That isn't Lusmore. Lusmore is hunched. Wait, it is you. How did this happen? How did you? And he told them the story of the fairies. Well, as small towns are wont to be, the story got around. And in another village over here, there was another man who had a hump. He was a miserable person. Never would do anything for anybody. But he heard the story of Lusmore, and he said, get rid of my hump. I can get rid of this thing on my back. So he did the same thing that Lusmore did. He went to the bank on the river at the same time of the month when the moon was up. And he went, and as he started hearing the singing, instead of waiting, he chimed right in. And the fairies were, who spoils our singing? Who's spoils it, and they see, look up, you spoiled our singing, and they gave him Lusmore's hump. Well, now he had two humps, and of course, with two humps on your back, you can't move. Poof, down he went. People from his village came looking for him, and they found him, laying there in pain, unable to move. Well, they carried him back, but he didn't live very long. So, if you're going to deal with the fairies, wait a little before you start singing.